Here's how to use Figma AI.
Most AI features in Figma are available at the last icon in your toolbar. If you don't see this star icon or have a completely different UI, check for updates. Figma gradually releases new features to current users, and if you really want to see them and still don't have access, the last thing you can try is to just create a new account. There are many AI tools here. I'll go from top to bottom. Some very important and helpful tools are actually at the end of the video, so make sure to watch the full video. The first tool is called First Draft. Click it, and you will see a checkbox. Input what you need into this checkbox. If this is your first time using this tool, feel free to just select the first example prompt. Figma will create a high-fidelity mockup based on your request. This frame is also built with layers of auto-layout frames, and all layers are clearly named. If you'd like to slightly change your device size, it's also relatively responsive. At the bottom, you can quickly switch between different suggested styles. On the bottom right, select the Make Changes button if you want to further customize this design. The first switch helps you toggle between light and dark mode. The color circles help you switch your accent color to something else. If you have a brand color, you can input it yourself by clicking here too. The second field allows you to edit the corner radius of this UI. You can use the slider to go from a sharp to a rounded look. The third field allows you to adjust the spacing of the UI. You can use the slider to go from a high-density look to a low-density look. The fourth field allows you to change text. At the top, you can select title text or body text, and you can use here to select the type of font for your text. At the bottom, there's also another button that says prompt. Instead of using the control panels, you can also input text to ask Figma to make changes for you. I find it funny that Figma trademarked the phrase "make it pop." Let's see how it works. Okay. That summarized all you need to know about the First Draft tool. AI tools like this can improve exponentially fast. So even if you don't find this helpful now, I highly recommend to check it again in a few months. Right now, I think this tool is strong in UI design, but it sucks in UX design. It is amazing at making everything look polished. It is amazing at aligning the elements. However, it thinks in screens. It doesn't think in flows. If you ask to make something, it also only provides a mobile screen, not a desktop one. And since it creates everything in high fidelity and auto layout, it actually becomes really difficult to edit if you want to make a lot of changes. So this is how I suggest you to use this. Use this as UI inspiration for each page of your design. However, I do not suggest using this when you don't have a clear flow in mind for your product's happy path. Now, let's click the star again in the toolbar and move to the next tool, Rename Layers. I think it's a great tool if you don't have the habit of naming your layers, or if you are still working on the early ideas of your product. You need to select the layers you want to rename. You can also select an entire frame, and then choose Rename Layers. This will help you rename all the layers you selected. And if you have a specific layer's name that you don't like, you can also select them again and run this tool again. Or just write them yourself. Remember, as a designer, you can always do it yourself. Don't take AI as the final answer. AI is just your free assistant that may make mistakes from time to time. Let's now click the star icon again and move to the next tool called Search with Images or Selection. This feature only works well if you have many components or are working with an extensive published design library. Let's say you want to find an icon, but forget its name. You can use any drawing tool to try to sketch what you're looking for and then group the drawing. Select what you draw, click the star icon and select find more like blah blah blah. This will open a window that browses through all your files and libraries. Here, in my case, if I go to components, I'll be able to see the right icon in my design system. And ta-da, it is called cast. I would never have guessed that. This find more like tool can also be used for an entire frame or image. Try it yourself. Next, we have the add interactions tool. If you have multiple screens of high-frame mockups but haven't added prototype interactions, select these frames and then try the Add Interactions feature. It will add interactions based on what it thinks is right. But remember, treat AI as your free assistant. Your assistant can make mistakes. You can always re-edit the interactions by adding it, deleting it, or editing it. Coming up, we have the Replace Content feature. The Replace Content feature currently only works for repeating frames like this one. It works similar to ChatGPT. I like it because you can rewrite many content all at once. To use this, select the element you want to rewrite content for. You can even just select the larger frame and then choose Replace Content. Figma AI will replace the text with similar content. If you wanted to replace it in a different way, you can click the Make Changes button again and describe your needs. Here we go. Figma AI just replaced the content based on what I needed. Next, we have the Shorten feature. This feature only works for text layers now. If you use it, it shortens the text. In UI, UX, and product design, there are so many scenarios where if you just shorten your content a little bit, then you don't have to make a button span too length or make a special edits to your layout. I guess that is why Figma included this feature as an individual button, even when you can already use the replace content and rewrite this feature to achieve similar things. However, as a UX designer, I have to tell you that I suggest designing your layers to work even with longer text. The day you have to design for a smaller mobile frame or expand your product to the Germany market, come back to thank me. Next, we have the rewrite this feature. This feature works on text layers and frames. You can ask it to make your content longer, shorter, more casual, more professional, whatever you like, or even just fix your grammar. And next, we have the translate to feature. I really wish I had this feature earlier. You can literally just select an entire frame or even multiple frames, choose translate to, select a language, and Figma AI will translate the entire page for you. Let us try German. See? I told you, everything looks longer in German. That is why I said you shall make your UI work even when the content get longer. This feature makes cross-border communication so much easier too. And coming up, we have the make an image feature. Feel free to click the button and try to make an image, and maybe get disappointed by it. I remember when ChatGPT first released its image feature, it was as bad as this. But after a few months, it got so much better. So let's not completely dismiss this one yet. And next, we have the remove background tool. It removes the background of your image. You can try it on the image that Figma just generated for you. When I saw this feature, the first thing that came to my mind is that, woo, this will make YouTube thumbnail editing so much easier. Because right now, I had to rely on the pen tool and the mask tool to crop myself out of a photo. It did a decent job of removing the background, but I still need to adjust a bit more. So for now, I'm gonna stick with the pen tool. The next AI feature is actually my favorite one. If you have a repeating block like this one, set up using auto layout, and if you want to add more elements to it, you can hover over the auto layout frame, and a sausage-shaped thing will appear at the bottom right of this frame. Of course, Figma doesn't call it sausage. Figma calls it duplicate with new content. Now try holding and dragging it. Ta-da! It will use your current layout, but with new content. This sausage feature is such a lifesaver.
If you learned something today, turn on all notifications to my channel, and this is part of the playlist where I teach you Figma. If you want to go one step further and learn how to design for big tech companies, then check out Fast Track UX. My name's Aliena, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in this video.